Hello students, good morning. I hope you all are doing well. I am Prithviraj. I am your class 9 physics teacher. I hope you all are following your social distance measures. You all are using masks and all. Okay. And for an advice, you should not come out. Okay. Okay. Today we will discuss a new chapter called motion. In our last class, we have read already. Matter around us. I hope you all have understood well and you have read it perfectly. In this session, it will be like this particular motion subject, like chapter will come under physics, right? So here people will be understanding lot of diagrams, lot of equations and all throughout the chapter. And basically in this chapter we will learn equations of motion and what is relative motion, and these things will use in your IITs as well. Those who are interested in pursuing higher careers, this particular concept is very useful for you all guys. So pay close attention. Okay, we will deal with it. We are familiar with the idea of motion when we see several examples of motion around us, like motion of people, vehicle, train, aeroplanes, bird, rain, object thrown in the air, etc. We know that it is due to the motion of the earth and the phenomena like sunrise, sunset, change in the season, etc. Student, what your like the way the introduction is given, they are saying that usually we all are familiar with lot of kind of motion, motion of a fan, motion of a bird, moving aeroplane, as well as the motion of the raindrops. Lot of kind of motions. Motion in the sense a body is moving from point A to point B, a matter is moving from point A to point B. That's what motion is. The motion of human as well. These all will be considered under motion itself, right? Now, what if a phenomena like sunrise, sunset, or your seasons, rainfall season, winter season, your summer season, how these all things comes? This is all due to a planet moving around the sun, right? So planetary motion is also very important for this all phenomena, right? Okay. Now, question arises, if Earth is in motion, why don't we directly perceive the motion of the Earth? See, Earth itself is moving, right? Around 1000 km per hour is the fast, like is the speed of the Earth. Not 1000, it is more than that. You can go up to like lakhs, 10 to the power 5 something. So it is moving that fast. Why we people are not getting the motion of the Earth? We will get the answer. And next, are the walls of your classroom at rest or in motion? The question is, in your classroom, the walls are at rest or they are in motion? If you are saying at rest, why? If you are saying yes, they are moving, then why? Then at last, have you ever experienced that the train in which you sit appears to move when it is at rest? Have you ever wondered, like, have you ever thought when you are sitting in a train, the train is at rest, but you people are thinking that the train is moving? Have you ever experienced these kind of things? Okay. To answer these all questions, let us go into this chapter. Student, what exactly to see? The motion which we are reading here, it is little bit tricky, not about distance, displacement, those things are, you might have completed in your 7th class, but here what we are dealing is relative motion, motion and relation. In our daily life, we use a lot of words, right? Like pencil, pen, give me a book, give me a pen, these all things, a lot of things are we people used to say. But the thing is, the word which you are speaking, if all words we will suppose 4 or 5 words according to subject verb agreement also, we will bring it closer and we'll try to make a sentence. Okay, still do like it is having a meaning. You people think yes sir is saying we will bring 4 or 5 words and we will follow all subject verb agreement, then the word, yes, the sentence will have a meaning. Okay, let me give you an example. The water is triangular. Yes, you heard right. I said the water is triangular. The sentence has any meaning? Like it is, it doesn't make any sense, right? This sentence doesn't have any sense on sense itself. Why? See, grammatically this is very perfect, very perfect. But there is no relation between the word water and triangular. The water is triangular. It doesn't make any sense, right? In the same way, if somebody is asking a body is at rest or body is at motion, it won't make any sense. It is all depends upon the observer who is looking at that object. You are standing and the bus is moving, then you will say yes, the bus is moving according to whom? With respect to you, the bus is moving. What about you sitting in a bus? You are moving or bus is moving? What exactly is happening? You will say, oh, a person, see, suppose we are sitting in a bus and a driver is also sitting with us. What exactly you will say? The driver is moving or driver is sitting? Yes, for you, the driver is sitting. But if I will be standing outside of the bus and I'll say, yes, the driver is moving with the bus. So here, if somebody is asking you a question, the object is moving or not, it completely depends upon the observer and the reference point by taking to which you are saying that yes, the object is moving with respect to that object or with respect to the particular situation. Okay, let's get deeper, you will understand. Suppose I'll say two persons are there. Suppose I'm walking on the road. Okay, let me walk on the road. Suppose I'm walking. Okay, another person is coming. Okay, another person is coming. Now, in my right side there is a plant. If I ask that boy who is exactly in front of me, what he will say? Yes, the plant is on my left side. I'll say, no, it is on my right side. We both are correct at some point, we both are wrong at some point. See, for him, if you want to take his example, he is correct. Yes, the particular thing which he is talking about, the plant, is in his left side. But for me, it is in right side. So the position of the object completely depends upon the situation of which, like, because of which you are taking consideration of. Suppose I am here standing. So to me, if you want to take me as a reference point, then that is right. If you want to take him as a reference point, that will be left. I think you can correlate this one, right? Next. So here, left and right both are what? Interrelated. Right? Interrelated to the same situation. And next, day or night. If somebody will ask, oh, this is a blue. Okay, somebody is there in Hyderabad, a person is there in New York. Suppose one of my friends is in New York, I am in Hyderabad. Now it is noon at Hyderabad, but the person who is sitting in New York, he will say it is midnight. Now here it is noon, he will say it is midnight. He is wrong or I am wrong? Nobody is wrong in this case. Yeah, we both are okay, we both are correct, but the question is, the point which you are taking reference, that has to be mentioned. Yes, for him he is at New York, then the timing is about night. For me, I am at Hyderabad, the timing is afternoon or morning. I hope you all are getting it right. The same way, if somebody will ask up and down, upside down also, okay, this is our north pole, this is our south pole. North pole you can see polar bears, south pole you can see penguins, right? Antarctica, you might have heard a continent called Antarctica is there, and you might have heard Russia, okay, Siberia region, that will be there in the north pole. So a person is standing over here and again another person is standing here. You will ask who is up, like upside down, and who is down. There won't be a certain answer you will get. You will get two kind of answer. He will say, yes, I am already on the ground. The person will say, yes, I am also on the ground. Both are on the ground only. And he is up, he will say, no, I am also up, he will say. Right? Students, from here, what you should come to know and what you have learned from here, that unless and until you are clear about the reference point, okay, you can never say either an object is at up or either an object is down. Either object is left or right, or is day or night, because they all are related to each other. The same will happen motion also. Motion is also relative. They all are related, they all are in relation with each other. In the same way, motion is also very much related to each other. How this motion is related to each other, how it is related, let us understand in the following example. Let me take a car, example of a car. Here is the thing. Okay, your car is moving. In this direction. Here there is a plant, suppose, on the roadside. Okay, there is a plant upon the roadside, and two persons here standing. They both are speaking with each other. They both are talking, right? So this is a tree. It's a car moving in that direction. The both persons are talking, or they both are speaking. Okay, standing on the road. Now, suppose consider the person's name is Srinu. Okay, and this person's name is suppose we consider Sonis. Somesh and Srinu, the both are talking. Okay. Now Srinu asks, "What is the state of motion of the tree?" Now Srinu asks Somesh that, "What is the station? What is the state of motion of the tree?" Eventually, Somesh will answer that, "Yes, the state of motion of tree is constant. The tree is not moving, right?" Okay. Somesh is correct. He is right. Now, Srinu is asking again another question. What is the state of motion of the car? He asked again to him. He said it is rest. Now again Srinu asks Somesh, what is the state of motion of car? He will say, yes, the car is moving. The car is moving. Again Srinu asks, what is the condition of driver and passenger which they are sitting in the car? He will say, yes, they are also moving with the car. So here he asks three questions. What is the state of motion of tree? What is the state of motion of car? What is the state of motion of the driver as well as the passenger who are sitting inside? Okay, and his answer is, it is rest and both are moving. Right? So from here what you people can decide? Yes, for motion, like for Somesh, he is at rest. And if you want to take him as a reference point, he is saying correct. Yes, because of him, whatever he spoke, the car is moving, the persons are moving, according to whom? According to Somesh. But now let us come to the second conversation between driver and passenger, okay? What exactly happening? Driver is asking now questions. Now what driver is asking to passengers? That, what is the state of motion of a tree? What is the state of motion of a tree? Now the passenger will say, the tree is moving to the west. This you might have understood what it's saying. Now this is eastward, okay? Right here, east. The car is moving east. Now the driver is asking to the passengers, what is the state of motion of a tree? The passengers will say that the tree is moving towards the west. It is going away in westward direction. Yes. If he is at west, according to him, the tree is moving west. Okay. Then for passenger asking, the driver is asking, what is the state of motion of both the person beside the road? He asks to this person. Driver is asking to passengers, what is the state of motion of the two persons who are standing on the road? And they both will answer that they are also moving west. They are also moving west. Again, he asks, what is the state of me? What is the state of me? What about my state of motion? Okay? Then the passenger will say that you are at rest. They are saying, you are at rest, you are sitting idly. You are just driving your bike, your car. Okay? So here students, one thing you need to consider. Anybody are wrong? See what both the conversation between Srinu and Somesh and conversation between driver and your passenger. Anybody are wrong here? No, right? They all are right. In their perspective, the plant is stable and it is in motion and they both are in motion. According to their perspective, the plant is moving, here they are moving and they are at rest. So here, fairly what from a good discussion, it is clear that the tree is at rest with respect to Somesh and it is moving with respect to the passenger. tree is redressed with respect to somas, and tree is at moving, tree is at motion with respect to passenger, right? So from here, students, one thing that is very clear: whenever a person is asking whether the object is moving or not, it completely depends upon the point or the observer who is looking at it. If an alien will be standing upon the moon and he will see the earth, he will say, yes, the earth is moving. Yes, he will say, because he is an alien, he is outside the world, and he is saying, he is looking at the earth. What he will look? That the earth is moving continuously. Like, I hope you all got my point. And this is what relative motion. Okay, in the next session we will learn, like, what exactly are the things, like what exactly are the attributes, or what exactly are the rules by which we people learn, like these all, motion, distance and all. So here basically we will be going relating with some of the concept related to equations of motion, distance, displacement. Okay, till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and please practice everything whichever I have taught till page number 40. Bye bye, students.